A very good morning to you all. The previous session, we have seen about information communication technology, internet, and distance learning program. So in that, we have detailedly discussed about what is information, what is communication, and what is technology, and also distance learning programs, advantages, and this few disadvantages and all. And today we will see one very interesting topic that is coming under 14th unit of our training methodology syllabus. So we'll see that in detail. The 14th unit is prepare for continuing professional development. So prepare for continuing professional development. That is the topic. Let us see the learning outcome. People are joining. So the today's session's topic is prepare for continuing professional development. Prepare for continuing professional development. So, as I told you yesterday, in our CITS, that is our DGT or NCVT system of training system or skill ecosystem, we have one module that is training methodology, which is a part of CITS. So, our CITS scheme, craft instructors training scheme, the training methodology is one module along with your trade skill and trade practical. So, training methodology mein, you know, the two terms are there, two words are there. Training matlab kya hai aur methodology, konsa methodology use karna hai? What is training? What are the methods or methodology we have to adopt to impart the training? Theory training as well as practical training. In collegiate education or university education, they have a research you know, studies in Master of Philosophy, MPhil, and PhD. So when you see the syllabus, they have one topic, they have one like training methodology, they have one research methodology. So research methodology consists of data collection, and putting the collected data will be kept in standard format. Then the data has to be analyzed properly. Before doing the research, they will have a problem. They will take a problem, then they will analyze the problem, then they will collect the data. So the statement will be very clear, and they will break the title into chunks. You know, you can say digestible chunks. So if you have the statement, very lengthy statement, you may not understand properly. So the statement has to be broken into so many pieces. Hello? Anji? Hello? Gas? हाँ बंदी जरा हाँ बनी बनी ओके एक्सक्यूज मी सो दे हैव इन अ कॉलेजिएट एजुकेशन दे हैव रिसर्च मेथडोलॉजी सो द रिसर्च मेथडोलॉजी डील्स विथ यू नो डेटा कलेक्शन एंड कीपिंग द डेटास इन एन ऑर्डरली मैनर एंड एनालाइजिंग द डेटा. So like that training methodology also, we have, you know, preparation, planning, presentation, and various types of visual aids preparation, and also developing the communication skills. So if you see the research methodology, each and every part will be analyzed properly. So the same manner, we can also analyze our topic, that prepare for continuing professional development. So you see, as an instructor, this is the final unit, the last unit of our training methodology subject. So prepare for, as an instructor, we have learned the role of instructor, responsibilities of instructor and psychology of learning, motivating the trainees, developing the personality of the trainees, then syllabus analysis, planning, preparation, demonstration plan, lesson plan, and various kinds of written instructional materials preparation and developing communication skills, testing, evaluation, everything we have seen, and we have developed all the skills and required knowledge. So now we have to do very important work. We have the responsibility to develop one more important skill, that is to continue our professional skills. That is very important. After the CTS course or after the CATS course, we should not stop our learning attitude or learning skill development process. So we always develop our knowledge, we always develop our skill, update our knowledge, update our skill related to our trade or related to our field. Then only we will be a successful person. So preparing for continuing professional development is the title, and the learning outcome, that is, this is a general learning outcome. If you systematically follow this content, that is what is available in the session, then you will be a successful instructor, and also you will see success in your professional as well as personal life. So the learning outcome, general learning outcome, is develop and implement continuous professional development plans. So as I told you, each and every word we can, we should understand, and we should be able to explain, and we should be able to, work out accordingly. So develop and implement continuous professional development plans. So we will see personal development means what, then we will see what is professional development, then we will learn how to prepare professional development plans. So these are the specific objectives of the general objective or learning outcome. Let us see the specific objective of the session. That means after completion of the session, you will be able to learn following or achieve following objectives or learning outcome or instructional objectives. So after completion of the session, you will be able to state the importance of continuous learning. So what is continuous learning and what are the importance of continuous learning, you will learn. Then you will explain personal development. What is personal development? Then you will be able to explain professional development. What is professional development? Then you will be able to develop professional development plans. So you know personal development, and you will know what is professional development. Next step is how to develop professional development plans. Then finally, you will set the professional development goals and objectives. These are the very important and very few, you see, very few, only five instructional objectives are there. So you please carefully observe the session. If you have any doubt at the end of the session, you can interact with me. I'm happy to talk to you. And you see, continuous learning means what? Continuous learning. You see, in psychology, we have seen learning is a psychological process. And learning leads to permanent change in behavior. We have seen learning leads to permanent change in behavior. So somebody's learning, there is no age limit for learning. Starting from childhood to old age, people can learn so many skills they can learn. And everybody will agree that it is a continuous process. So after learning or acquiring certain amount of skills, we have to continue our learning habits, because it will yield fruitful results and we will be a successful individual. That is why people used to say autonomous learners. Autonomous learners are people who will always have interest to learn from the people, learn from the resources, learn from internet, learn from papers, books, like that. So autonomous learner. So why a person should be an autonomous learner? So you see, learning will not occur only in the school or colleges or classrooms or training institutions. So wherever we have opportunity, we should be ready to learn. So let us see continuous learning importance. Continuous learning, the only thing that is constant is the change. The only thing that is constant is the change. You know, many of you might have heard this. The only thing that is constant is the change. The only thing that is constant is the change. So which will always continuously change, that is the change that has been told by Heraclitus, and he is a Greek philosopher. Like we have seen in mentoring and counseling, few philosophers who are the mentors and for the mentees, followers, and Heraclitus also a Greek philosopher who lived more than 2500 years before, and he only stated that the only thing that is constant is the change. So change is the only constant in life. So all will agree that change is the only constant in life. One's ability to adapt to those changes will determine your success in life. So why I am mentioning this phrase or a golden word for change. So we should not stop our learning process, or we should not stop our learning skill habit. Always we should have the habit of learning. Always we should try to change, adapt to change ourselves in a good, better, best, towards a good, better, best. So change is the only constant in life. One's ability to adapt to those changes will determine your success in life. Continuous learning is about the constant expansion of skills and change in attitude through learning and improving knowledge. So continuous learning means it is not restricted to the syllabus, it is not restricted to your basic skill or advanced skills. It is a continuous process. So continuous learning is about the constant expansion of skills and change in attitude through learning and improving the knowledge. So this slide particularly deals with what is continuous learning, what is the importance of continuous learning. Hope you understood what is continuous learning. Then personal development. What is personal development? In personality development, we have seen what is personal development and what is personality development. Personal development is a individuals, self, ourself. And personality is the individual qualities, the knowledge, skill, and attitude, behavior, which influence on others. That is a personality. So we have discussed and seen the difference with personal and personality. Let us see personal development. What is personal development? So personal development is a process of improving oneself through communication skills, employability skills, increasing consciousness, and building wealth. So personal development means individual growth towards the communication skill and employability skill and increasing the consciousness and building the wealth. So these are the personal development of an individual. Let us see what is few more example for personal development. Personal development can also include developing others' skill and personality. This may take place through roles such as those of a teacher or mentor. So mentors also should develop some kind of personal qualities, and teachers also to develop some personal qualities. So these are the personal developments. And few elements which plays important role to develop our personal development. So that means education. See, we should have education. Education is the basic a requirement of an individual. So a person should be educated enough to be a good human being in life. So it may be a basic education or higher education, doesn't matter, but at least a basic education a person should have. Education makes better person, and training makes better performer. So education and training both are important for a human life. So personal development, education is very important. We should acquire our educational qualification. And if opportunity comes, we have to update our qualification, do diploma or degree, or if you have degree, then post-graduation and all. Then self-awareness. We should have awareness about ourselves and also around the world. So self-awareness is very important. First, we must know about ourselves. What is our potential? What is our strength? What is our weakness and all? Self-awareness. So about personal development, we must know all these elements. So one by one we are discussing. Then building employability skills. So as an instructor or as a trainee or as an individual or as a learner, we must build employability skills according to our basic qualification so that we can get job opportunities in good companies or good organizations because organization always choose the best person for their company or organization. So we have to attend interview. We should be picked by the organization. If interview being conducted means we have to be picked by that company. So for that we need employability skills. We need to develop ourself in employability skills. Employability skills which consist of communication skills, team working, and confident and stress management, time management, everything like that. A lot of soft skills are involved in employability skills. And identify weakness, that is very important. So as an individual, we have a strength and weakness, and we should also analyze the threats and opportunities. So this SWOT analysis is very important, not only for institutions and also for the individuals. So identify our weakness. So individual weakness we should know. Then only those weakness can be replaced by strength. We can replace our weakness through learning, gaining knowledge or gaining skill or changing our attitude. Everything is possible. Only we have to know our weakness. Then build strength. Once we identified our weakness, then next is building our strength. Then motivation. Motivation we have seen. There are two types of motivation. One is self-motivation, intrinsic. The other one is extrinsic, motivated by others. So motivation factors are also very important for the personal development. Then improve health. Health also very important. We should take care of our health for our personal development. Improving health is very important element. Then improve wealth. So if we have education, if we have strength, and if we identified our weakness, then if we develop our strength, avoiding the weakness, then if we build our employability skill, if we have very good employment opportunity, if we joined a company and if we earn money, then if we take care of our wealth, I mean health, then automatically our wealth also will improve. At the same time, apart from our knowledge, skill, and wealth, health, one more important thing is our intelligent quotient and emotional quotient. So we have to improve our IQ as well as EQ, intelligent quotient and our emotional quotients. So these are all very important. So, and also stress management and time management. So these are the important elements which plays very important role in personal development. So we have seen personal development. What is personal development? What are the important elements plays very important role in personal development? Let us see the next objective as per our session. That is personality development. So professional development. Professional development. So professional means what? Again, we have to define both the terms, like information communication technology, how we have defined what is information, what is communication, what is technology. Likewise, we can also define here what is professional and what is development. So we have seen personal development. Personal means ourselves, hamara. And professional means our qualities or qualifications, which will help us to gain better employment and score higher qualifications and gain more skills and do our employment or perform our job very well. These are all professional activities. So it is very special. So in the we have seen professional course and degree courses, science and arts and science and professional courses. For joining professional courses, you require lot of marks. 90%, 99%, 99.5, like that, people will score. So the professional institutions, professional colleges where engineering, medicine, agriculture and all will be selected through written test, and also they are based on their marks. So who has scored, secured more marks, because that is a special course. So professional means special. And the professional development, specialty of an individual, ourself. So we have to develop some special qualities that is called professional development. For what? To gain knowledge, to be a successful individual, and to get good employment opportunity, and also in the existing employment or existing job also, we can perform very well. We will be the best employer if we have that professional development skills. So professional development is learning to earn or maintain professional credentials. So we can earn as well as if we do business, then our profit, our company will get more profit. We can show more profit, more productivity every year. If you are an employee of a particular company, we can also maintain our professional credentials such as getting technical and academic qualifications, gaining formal training, attending workshops, and any learning opportunities for self-development is professional development. So for the self-development, what are the opportunities you are getting? It may be attending training program, formal training program, or gaining qualifications, academic qualifications, or any technical qualifications. Everything is involved with the professional development. And professional development, professional development, informations, related informations, any professional development method will include following common elements, which are, professional development plan are adopted in institutions, in industries, in public sectors, and so many fields, even schools, colleges, and all. So for teacher education in schools and college, for students as well as the teachers. So professional development method is there, like lesson plan method. Every level, school, college, higher education level, they are having lesson plans. The format may be different, but the content, the preparation, motivation, review, and teaching aids are objectives, which is very important, and all based on the standard lesson plans. Like that, professional development plan also, people may have different methods, but the following elements are very common elements for professional development. Let us see what are those elements. Plan your approach. So we have to plan first. We have an approach to develop our professional skills or professional knowledge. That is our professional development plan. Then we have to do plan. Plan our approach, then do active your plan. So simply planning without processing or progress is not correct. There will not be any development or progress. So after the plan, we have to activate it. We have to proceed further according to our plan. And regularly measure and record your activities. So regularly we have to see, weekly schedule, monthly schedule, and master schedule we have. To achieve the master schedule successfully, if you want to achieve the master schedule, and if we want to have the success, at the end, then progress we have to see time to time. Regularly we have to proceed towards our goals, and sometimes time to time we have to measure how much we have completed, how much we have what are the problems we have faced. If we measure, then we can see some problems. Theoretically some problem, or practically some problem, or some tools and equipments problem. Those problems we have to identify and rectify those problems. So regularly measure and record your activities. Then reflect, apply the outcome of your learning in your work. And we have to reflect that, and we have to apply something we are gaining, means we have to apply that outcome in our work. So these are the important elements of professional development. And some standard professional development plan: do, record, reflect, plan. First one is plan, then do as per the plan, perform as per the plan, then record it, then reflect it, again if needed you again plan, replan, then redo in a different manner. So this is the one of the professional development plans. So plan means what? Develop your professional development plan. So we have to develop. After a CTS course, I have to get job, or I have to join in CITS course. After a CITS course, I should get a job in ITI or any industry, preferably any teaching job. So after gaining few years experience, at least 2 years experience, then you are eligible to get a state government or central government job as an instructor or as a junior training officers. So you have to develop a plan for that. So to become a teacher, what are the plans required? You have the qualification with you. You have certificate for that. You have to search for that, for the job. You have a lot of opportunities. You can, some of our trainees joined demonstrators or teachers, guest faculties in schools also to teach government related subjects and to teach computer related subjects. So it is not only ITIs or it is not only National Skill Training Institutes. So where you have the skill, where they require your skill, you can join as a teacher or as an instructor. So first you have to plan, then proceed. Undertake your planned continuous development plan. So undertake your planned CPD means what? Continuing professional development. So you have professional development plans. So you have to continue that, you have to perform. So undertake your planned activities and then log and provide evidence of your continuous professional development activities. So log note means what? Log book, what you will do, day-to-day activities you are recording in your log book. So like that, our professional development plan should have schedules like daily schedule, weekly schedule, monthly schedule, as well as the master schedule. And every time progress should be, measured. Then only you will see the problems and any lack in that, then you can overcome that and you can solve the problems with the help of, experts, or you can discuss with your seniors and all. And reflect on your learning. So after analyzing your progress, it will reflect. You can apply what is the problem, what is the mistake, or where you are doing well, then you can apply so that your performance will be better. So reflect on your learning. So these are the plan, do, record, reflect elements of professional development plan. And again, like personal development, professional development also, some important elements plays very important role. So first one, let us see from existing knowledge. So again, this is not only for an individual who has the degree or diploma. It is for everyone who would like to develop their professional skills. And CTS trainees who want to develop their professional skills, they can also apply all these elements. And CITS trainees, after successful completion of CITS training program, then they have to continue their professional development activities, learning the knowledge and gaining the skill and all. And you may be a graduate and you may be an employee of an industry or any organization. You have to, if you concentrate to develop your professional skills, if you have the plan, professional development plan, and your activity, your skill, your attitude, your knowledge will definitely develop, and you can perform better than the previous month or previous years. So we must know the existing knowledge. Whatever knowledge we have to list out. Our past basic knowledge hai computer mein. Iske saath kya kya additional knowledge chahiye? Additional knowledge kya kya chahiye? Sirf Microsoft Word pata hai, Microsoft Office applications pata hai. Mere ko DTPO, desktop publishing operators ka skills seekhna chahiye. Then only you can become as desktop publishing operator, or you can design your own designs so that you can get orders. You can be a entrepreneur, self employment. You can do your own business having one computer system with the desktop publishing operator softwares like CorelDRAW, Photoshop and all. You can do your own business. For that you should know what the knowledge I should need. What are the knowledge, what are the skills I should have, I should pursue. So existing knowledge you list out, then existing skill you list out. So practical knowledge and practical skill, theory knowledge and practical skill. Then present experience, so list out your experience. If you do not have any experience, you join to gain any experience related to your trade. So gain experience, make a career plan. So you have listed your knowledge, you have listed your skill, existing skill, and present experience you have listed. The next step is plan. Make a career plan. Then create a roadmap. So roadmap means like lesson plan. Lesson plan is a teacher's detailed description of a course of instruction, one definition. And one definition is a roadmap for an instructor. It is a roadmap. Lesson plan is a roadmap for an instructor. What is the meaning of roadmap? See, through the path we can walk, through the road we are traveling like that to reach our destination. So to create a roadmap, with the help of these important elements to reach the goal or to reach our destination. Our destination may be to achieve our long term or short term goals, to become a competent instructor, to become a successful trainee, or to become a successful employee of an organization. You may have so many goals. So how to set the goals, in the following slides we will discuss detailly. So create roadmap for that to achieve our target. Then set goals, SMART goals. In the writing instructional objective session we have seen, and planning session also we have seen how to set goals systematically, specifically. For that we should follow one rules, that is SMART approach. So set SMART goals. SMART goals are achievable, specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, and time bound. So our goals should be specific and measurable, and also achievable, realistic, and time bound. So again we will see detailly with examples for the SMART goals the following slides. So this is also one of the important elements of professional development. Then gain knowledge, skill, and experience. See, we have seen here, first existing knowledge we have listed, existing skill we have listed, existing experience we have listed. पहले क्या किया professional development के लिए, पहले हमारे पास क्या knowledge है, अभी हमारे पास क्या knowledge है, अभी हमारे पास कौन सा skill है, क्या skill है, और हमारे पास कितना साल का experience है और कितने महीने के experience के है, और एक्सपीरियंस नहीं है वो भी परवाह नहीं है, लिस्ट करना है, लिस्ट आउट करना है. फिर इसके बाद गेन न्यू नॉलेज एंड स्किल एंड एक्सपीरियंस. सो उसके बाद प्लान किया, और प्लान करने के बाद वी हैव टू यू नो प्रोसीड टुवर्ड्स दैट टू अचीव. उसको अचीव करने के लिए क्या क्या करना, न्यू नॉलेज, नया नॉलेज गेन करना, और नया स्किल सीखना, और एक्सपीरियंस भी we have to gain, experience bhi gain karna. So uske liye kya karna, job, we have to search for job, employment opportunity dekhna. We have to join in a company related to our trade or profession. Then better presentation skills. So we also should improve our presentation skills, you know. Communication skills, presentation skills are very important for professional development, because whatever we have in our mind should be expressed without fear and clearly. And in that way, if we present well, then whatever we have made, maybe a product or whatever idea we may have, we can present in an understandable manner to our colleagues or our superiors. So better presentation skill is very important professional quality. And strengthen professional relationship. So professional relationship also we have to strengthen. The employee, like employee relationship, we should also strengthen our professional relationship with our subordinates or with our superiors and with our own colleagues. And compare and assess your progress. So we have listed the existing knowledge, we have listed the existing skill, and listed the experience. Then we have made a plan, and we have prepared a roadmap to achieve our goal, and we have set the SMART goal, achievable, realistic goals, specific goals. Then we have listed the, we have gained the knowledge, we are going to gain the skill and experience, and we are also developing better presentation skills, and we are also strengthening our professional relationship among people. Then everything we are following, at the same time periodically we have to assess our progress. So this is very important. So hamara progress kaisa hai, abhi kaisa hai, pehle mahine kaise tha, abhi kaisa hai, aur next month isse achhi taraf hamara professional development hona chahiye. Aise to compare that we should check our time to time we have to check our progress, so that better than the previous, good, it is good now, tomorrow it will be better, and day after tomorrow it will be best, it will be the best. So good, better, best, good, better, best. For that purpose we have to assess our progress. So these are the important elements of professional development. And you see why this professional development, what is the necessity of professional development? You see this picture, see here we are, we have knowledge, we have education, we have qualification, and we have certificate, educational qualification certificates, we have training certificates, we have. If we see right side, you see career is very important. So after the qualification, after gaining the degree excuse me, we should have, you know, we should see our career is in a better place. We are earning money. You see, a very good, you know, wealthy thing is there. It may be a salary, good salary, or very good company, and wealth. Maybe some, you know, fruitful result you are seeing here. So for that, what you require? Professional development. You got it. So here we are. We have education. To achieve this, what is required is professional development. And next, see, goal setting. About goal setting, we were talking. It may be a short-term goal or a long-term goal, and a few important elements we have to consider while setting the goal. Why we have to set the goal? Because we have to develop ourselves, personal development as well as professional development. So for that personal development or professional development, we have to set the objectives, or we have to set the goals. Like our lesson plan, systematically we have to prepare instructional objectives. The SMART approach has to be followed. In goal setting also, many professional institutions, many industries, IT or electronics or mechanical industries, people are following this principle. That is goal setting principle, that is SMART approach. S stands for specific, M stands for measurable, A stands for achievable, R stands for realistic, time stands for time bound. Specific means should specify what you want to achieve. हमारा अचीवमेंट क्या होना चाहिए, अभी हमारा स्टेटस कैसा है, हमारा नॉलेज कितना है, हमारा स्किल कितना है, उसके बाद तो क्या अचीव करना, एम्प्लॉयमेंट में अचीव करना और हायर स्टडीज में अचीव करना, वो स्पेसिफिकली हमारे पास होना चाहिए. शुड स्पेसिफाई व्हाट डू यू वांट टू अचीव, क्या अचीव करना है, दैट शुड बी स्पेसिफिक. देन मेजरेबल, एबल टू मेजर वेदर यू आर मीटिंग द गोल ऑब्जेक्टिव आर नॉट. See, really, it has to be measured. Simply, something we should not have. I'll become as like this. I'll become as like this. It should be achievable, and you know, and it should be measurable. So, and we should have the potential. We should have the capacity to achieve that goal. So, all those goals only, all those objectives only, we should have. We should not dream for something which is not at all possible, which is not impossible. So we should always dream which is possible at our level with our capacity. For that, what are the knowledge we required for that? What are the skills we require for that? What are the attitude, change in attitude required? We can develop. So the goal should be measurable, and whether you are meeting the objectives or not, then it should be achievable. What is the meaning of achievable? Are the goal or objectives you set achievable and attainable? Is it really achievable? Is it possible to start a small scale industry with that? See, after your CTS program or after your CTS certificate and CVT certificate, you can start a business with 5 lakhs loan, or you may have you can start a business with 5 lakhs maximum. So 500 crores, you should not think I will start a business with 500 crores. For that, you should have the knowledge and you should have experience, and it should be achievable. Are the goal objectives you set achievable and attainable? If you think 5 lakhs rupees, I can start a small scale industry or small business. Yes, it is possible. 500 crores means it is not imaginable. If you have the money with you, then how you will spend that? That plan and all you will not have, and the experience you do not have. So that is not achievable, and that is also not realistic. So what is the meaning of realistic? Can you really achieve the objectives with the resources you have? So for 5 lakhs rupees, you can purchase 5-6 systems with the printers and including softwares, so that you can become as a, you can have a computer center with the DTPO work. You can design visiting cards. You can design wedding cards or any greeting cards. So you will be an entrepreneur. It is realistic. So with the help of 5 lakhs rupees, you can start your own business. You are an entrepreneur. You have the experience for after 10 years, you have gained a very good experience. After 10 years, you can have for 500 crores also, even 1000 crores also you can have, because you will have very good experience and you will have the link and you have the network and you can have the vision to implement a very big scale industry. For that, you should have experience. So you should think whether it is realistic. Really, we can do that. That is very important. Then time. When do you want to achieve the set goals or objectives? It may be a short-term goal or it may be a long-term goal. For our lesson plan, 30 minutes, we are going to teach one lesson. For that 30 minutes, what are the objectives? It is very, very specific. So 4 objectives, listed statements are only 4. The learning outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4. So within the 30 minutes, we are achieving that those objectives. But for here, this professional development and all, we can have short-term goals or long-term goals according to our requirement. So these are the important elements of goal setting. Then some, you know, examples. For some professional development plans. After CTS course, after CITS course, we can ask our trainees to prepare a professional development plan. One individual acquired training at our training institution and he or she successfully completed her course or his course, CTS course completed or CITS course completed. Now, what is a personal development plan? What are the plans she or he can have? We have seen what are the important elements required for a personal development as well as the professional development. You see this is a model. You can change this according to your requirement and you can set goals first. Personal development plan ke liye kya kya chahiye? Goals, knowledge competency or skills competency or remarks. This is just a model. According to your requirement, you can prepare your own. You can set your own goals. Like here, become as a manager in a company. You are garment trainee or a DTPO trainee or a computer operator trainee or any fitter trainee, any mechanical trade related trade trainee. So your goal may be, your broad ambition may be become as a manager in a company. For that, what you should do, first you should acquire the skill and you should have the knowledge, competent knowledge in that subject and competent skill. You should have a skill related to that. Competency means what? You are professional enough to perform the skill. You are professional enough to demonstrate the skill, or you have the knowledge, complete knowledge about the subject. That is called competency. And your existing level after successful completion of the training, that is called competency. So knowledge competency, you should fill up here. What are the things you have? And skill competency, you have to fill up here. And remarks which you do not have or which you require, you can fill up here. So you can set a long-term goal as a manager or short-term goal, I should get job in a good company. That may be a short-term goal. For that, what you should do to get good job in a good company means you have to search first. You have to search a good company and what is their requirement? What is the company's requirement? And what are the skills or knowledge we have to develop to be selected from the company? If you attend the interview or if you attend the written test, you have to pass in that. You have to attend the interview and you have to pass in the interview also. So what are the skills required to successfully pass in the test with good marks and interview skills? So we have to develop all those competencies, skill as well as knowledge. So we have to set the goal, short-term goal like getting employment in a company, but become as a manager. So you see, if you get a job in a very good company, then you should perform well. If you show your performance very well, disciplined manner, is a very good operator, he's a very skilled person means, then every year there will be a progress in your career and your post may be a trainee, then you will be a skilled worker, then you will be a supervisor, then you will be an assistant manager, then after 5-10 years you will be a manager. This is a real fact and we have seen so many trainees are managers and even senior managers in companies. So these are the personal development plans you can have. As a teacher, you can have professional development plans. For example, this is a professional development plan, a model for an instructor. So we have seen so many duties and responsibilities are there for an instructor. Foremost important role is to play as an instructor and as a manager. He has to manage the institute and manage the his or her own trade, maintaining the equipments of her or his own trade. And also, as an instructor, she or he has to impart training theory as well as practical. And apart from that, we also should develop our personal, professional skills, like updating our knowledge, updating our skill, and gaining new knowledge, particularly in computer related, so computer software related, communication, better communicator and all, we have to develop. And we have, we can see, I have prepared one schedule for 3 months as an instructor. Apart from theory teaching, practical teaching, you have to link the industries with the institute. So you will play link or network. You will be the link with the industry and the training institute. So we have our trainees. After successful completion of the training, they will get job. They have to go to apprenticeship training. Even during the course of training also, we have one on-the-job training or dual system of training. DST is dual system of training. So when we are undergoing training, our trainees are undergoing training, at the same time, 1 year course means at least 3 months they should go to an industry to get actual experience, the industrial experience they will have. They will work if they are architect, and they will go to an architect industry, architectural assistantship trainee means they will go to architectural assistantship company, and they will they know the basic architectural softwares. The company requirement, if they are doing small buildings like 5-story buildings, then if they go to company, they may design 50-story buildings. The basic skills, basic designs, they know in a bigger manner, they will have the experience while working in the company. So like that, they will have the real experience. For garment trainees, they know the stitching of garments, children's garment, ladies garment, and gents garments. They know the stitching and they know embroidery and all. Though if they go to the garment industry, then the machines maybe maximum power machines will be there, and they know how to operate power machine, but the material, the garments may be different, so the sizes may be different, and the working culture may be different than the training institute atmosphere. So they will have the real experience if they work in the industry. That is why dual system of training is introduced. So that has to be followed by an instructor. So in 3 months, what will be the goal of an instructor? This is for example. So like personal development plan, how we have seen for a trainee, and this is for an instructor, a model professional development plan for an instructor. So 3 months, what will be the goal? Contact at least 3 industries for on-the-job training, dual system of training, and sign MOU. So we have to sign MOU. So for example, in our institute, all the trades, we have signed MOUs with the industries. Like that, respective trade in charges will have contact with the industries, and they might have signed MOUs for their trainees, so that their trainees can work in the industry as trainees. Then 6 months, what will be the goal? Join a refresher course, any topic related to training methodology or soft skills. So for an instructor, soft skills are very important. In soft skills, time management, stress management, anger management, and also, communication skills, personality development, so many skills are required. So you are very good in your subject. You have subject knowledge, very good subject knowledge, and you have very good skill related to your subject, related to your trade. Apart from that, you require so many other skills like computer skills and using PowerPoint presentations effectively, how to use effective PowerPoint presentations, how to speak properly in an understandable manner, and how to make a presentation properly. Like there's so many skills an instructor can learn. For that, you require, you can set in 6 months, I will gain these skills, I will learn these skills, I'll undergo training programs or any refresher course. So for instructors, our department itself sending trainees to many places. Our own department also, their Central Staff Training and Research Institute in Calcutta. So our own staff members from various NSTAs, they can go to that CSTRI and undergo training programs. 1 week program, 2 weeks programs, like that. Short term courses are there. And even our own place, near to our place also, we can get the details and get the approval from the competent authority. So we can join. So that in a 6 months, we can develop a training methodology skills and soft skills. That will be the 6 months goal. And 1 year, that is 12 months, you may have some goals. That is join career development programs, any new courses to update knowledge. So you have, you may have a diploma qualification, or you may have CTS and CATS qualification. You are an instructor. For basic qualification is CATS, CTS, then CATS course, and the minimum 2 years of experience. So you may have 5 years or 10 years experience. You are an instructor. After that, what you should do, you should think in what way we can develop our professional skills, in what way we can develop our professional knowledge and all. So we can join some course, 6 months diploma course or 1 year diploma course. You can update, so that you can update your knowledge and skill related to your trade. So your career development programs you can join in an year. And after, within 3 years, you can see the 36 months in 3 years. So if you have only ITI certificate, then you can think about joining diploma course. So after ITI, you can also, pursue your graduation. BA, you can join. BCom, you can join. BSc, you can join through NIOS, National Institute of Open Schooling. So National Institute of Open Schooling is an organization, government approved organization, where if you approach them after your ITI, if you approach them, they will conduct only one test. That is your proficiency test, in language proficiency test, basic language skills they will test. Then after passing that, you can join BA degree, BSc degree, or any bachelor's degree, any universities across the country. So that is possible. So after ITI, in 3 years, I will join one diploma course, or 3 years, I will join one degree course. Like that, you can have a goal. So identify successful trainees and motivate, guide them to become as an entrepreneur. So one is updating your skill, upgrading your qualification. The next is you can identify some successful trainees and some entrepreneurs are there. See, we have trainees, they are having their own business and they are getting turnover like that 25 to 30 lakhs per annum. So they are earning more than us. So we have to identify all those people, successful trainees, alumni, successful alumni, so that we can motivate our existing trainees. We can call them, we can bring them, we can have a network, so that they are the motivators for the present trainees. So by seeing them, so we also should become as an entrepreneur. We also should become as that person, like that. So our past our trainees' success also very good motivational or inspiration thing for our existing trainees. So these are the 3 months, 6 months, 12 months or 36 months duration goals. And accordingly, we can choose our goals, or we can also have our own goals. And what is the achievement? We can see here any problems or any intricacies or any barriers we can note down. And all the barriers or problems can be solved systematically if we approach. So these are the professional development plans and the personal development plans as per our objectives. So with this, I'm concluding the session. As per the plan, we have, in our syllabus, we have the continuing professional development plan. We have to prepare our trainees, CATS trainees, to prepare for continuing professional development plan. So continuous learning, the importance of continuous learning, we have seen change is the only constant in life. So one's ability to adopt those changes will determine your success. So always we should be a good learner. Always we should update our knowledge. Always we should update our skill. That is very important. And once we have that attitude, we have to update knowledge, skill, and personal development, professional development, then our general outcome or the learning outcome will be we will be developing and implementing the continuous professional development plans. So we have seen some models, also model plans for personal development, what are the elements required, and for professional development, what are the elements required. We have seen this is for personal development, and professional development also we have seen this one. These are the elements for professional development. For everything, we have to identify the existing knowledge, existing skill, and present experience or existing experience. Then list the list out what are the required knowledge, skill, and experience. Then work towards that. Set the goals and work towards the goals, and definitely we will see the success. So these are the important points which we have discussed in prepare for continuing professional development. So if you see the title. If you see the unit number 14, this is a revised syllabus as per the National Skill Qualification Framework, NSQF framework. We have this new topic for this time. And if you see prepare for continuing professional development, people may feel that this is new and it may not be interested like that. Very, very, very interesting. You might have experience. Very interesting topic. How to personally we can develop ourselves, how to become a professional professionally how to build ourselves like that. And with this information, I will conclude the session. If you have any doubts or clarification, for 5 minutes you can ask me. I'll see any messages sometimes. Can we get 5 lakhs to start a business? Yeah, you see, amount is secondary. First one, you should have the qualification. Then you should have a project proposal. You submit your project proposal. This is your skill. This is your knowledge. This is your experience. And you can achieve this like a project you prepare and approach a bank. So many opportunities are available in bank, and government also giving lot of opportunities. Definitely, see, 5 lakh is what? One system, 55,000 rupees. One computer system you can buy, and one printer also for 15,000-20,000 rupees. You can get a printout. With the help of one system and one printer, you will be an entrepreneur. You can get job for typing, for project, preparing a project proposals and all. And if you have a desktop publishing softwares like Photoshop, CorelDRAW and all, nearly a lakh rupees. And within 2 lakhs rupees, you can have wonderful softwares and wonderful business opportunities if you are computer related trade. And if you are belong to dressmaking, means you can have sewing machines. You can get some people who know stitching, and you can give employment opportunities for them to purchase sewing machines. One sewing machine costs how much, and 5 machines or 10 machines how much, and the space is required, how much space you have. Accordingly, you can prepare a project proposal and submit to the institutions where they are helping you. There are so many places people are helping for employment opportunities as well as the business opportunities. And C-Star-I is an organization, they are giving staff training for training methodology and other training programs for the staff, teaching faculties. I only know MS Office like Word, PowerPoint, Excel, basic computer, internet. What more should have job opportunity? So see, there are two things. Whatever skill you have, whatever knowledge you have, with the availability of knowledge and skill, you can get job. Okay. And the company, the salary may be different. And some companies will offer you a very good post or very good with very good salary. They may require some other additional skills and additional knowledges. So to meet those things, you have to learn a few more knowledge and few more skills related to that particular field. So it all depends on your requirement. It all depends on your choice. So which is your choice? Whether existing qualification and existing knowledge, getting job, or you want to get a job in that particular industry with that particular salary, for that what is your requirement, where and all you can develop your knowledge, skill and experience. So all those things you develop so that you can get, face that interview, you can be selected in that from that in the, you know, company industry. So there are two things. Anything else? Personal development measured by education? No, personal development is not only measured by education. Personal, you know, the elements which we have discussed, personal, our communication skill, our educational qualification, our health, wealth and all personal. So everything is involved, not only education. What is the full form of CPD? Continuous professional development. That is our topic, continuous professional development or continuing professional development. Continuing, we have to continue that. We have to continue our professional development plans. We have to continue our qualification, our career development and all. So continuing professional development or continuous professional development only, CPD. Anything else? What type of courses available in C*? Go to website, go to Google, type C*, then you will get the list of courses. There are so many courses, time to time they are introducing. Then what are the courses for the forthcoming months? You can get the detailed information about the courses being conducted at C*. For our instructors, we can get BA, BSc admission through NIAS. Yeah, so I told you, know, again, you go to NIAS website and you will get the detailed information. You have to pass ITI. After passing your ITI, it may be engineering or non-engineering trade, 1 year course or 2 years course, doesn't matter. After successful completion of your ITI course, then approach NIAS, then you get detailed information about pursuing your college degrees. Anything? Maybe Hindi mein ba, you know, koshish kiya aur try bhi kiya, Hindi mein bhi baat kiya. Kyunki pura most of the terms are in English. So sara terms translate karne ke liye bahut mushkil hai, usliye transcribe kiya. So any other doubts? Sir, I'm doing CATS and I have done engineering diploma. I want to do BTEC. Yeah, you can see with the diploma course, you can join, you know, second year. If you have diploma in electronics engineering, electronics and communication engineering, then you can join second year BE course in BA electronics course in an engineering college. It's possible. So.
Sir, I guess there are no further questions. So
yes, madam. Yeah. Please end the meeting, madam. Just I was replying to the questions in the chat box. Sir. Yeah, madam. Over.